7-2.
The flag about to be raised. And there it goes. They're under orders for the champion hurdle, and they're running, and Paiute for France is the first to show. Paiute goes on from Pollardstown and Monk's Field, and then Bird's Nest and Norfolk Dance, Connaught Ranger, Royal Boxer, and then Broadleys and Sea Pigeon as they come to the first of the eight flights. And Paiute with a commanding lead as he comes to the first and jumps his first English hurdle in public quite well. He clipped the top but didn't lose any impetus whatsoever. Martin Blackshaw on Paiute in the lead from Monk's Field and Pollardstown, then Bird's Nest and Royal Boxer and Norfolk Dance, and Broadleys, Connaught Ranger and Sea Pigeon. And not going a very fast pace at the moment. Monk's Field taking quite a strong hold with Desi Hughes, and it's Paiute, Monk's Field, a little between the two. Then comes Pollardstown and Bird's Nest and Royal Boxer and Connaught Ranger and Norfolk Dance and Broadleys and Sea Pigeon as they come to the next. Paiute and Monk's Field over it together from Pollardstown and Bird's Nest and Royal Boxer and Connaught Ranger and Norfolk Dance, Sea Pigeon and Broadleys as they swing left-handed, and Monk's Field has taken a fractional advantage from Paiute, these two disputing it from Pollardstown on the inside of Bird's Nest, then Connaught Ranger, then comes Royal Boxer, Norfolk Dance, Broadleys and finally Sea Pigeon as they race towards the top of this first hill. Paiute on the inside of Monk's Field, Bird's Nest and Pollardstown next, then comes Connaught Ranger, Royal Boxer, Norfolk Dance, Sea Pigeon and finally Broadleys as they run downhill towards the third flight. Paiute for France from Monk's Field, Pollardstown and Bird's Nest, Broadleys on the inside, Connaught Ranger towards the outer, then Norfolk Dance, Sea Pigeon and Royal Boxer, and a beautiful jump there by Sea Pigeon takes him much closer to the leaders, Paiute and Monk's Field. Then Bird's Nest on the outside, Pollardstown. Then Sea Pigeon, Royal Boxer, Broadleys, Connaught Ranger and Norfolk Dance. Coming down to the fourth flight and the halfway mark in the champion hurdle, and it's Paiute and Monk's Field. Going to jump it pretty well together. Paiute and Monk's Field. Monk's Field on the outside of Paiute. Very close to them, Pollardstown and Bird's Nest, Broadleys, Royal Boxer, Connaught Ranger, Sea Pigeon and Norfolk Dance. Racing uphill now, and it's Paiute from Monk's Field and Pollardstown, Bird's Nest, Connaught Ranger, Broadleys, Royal Boxer, Norfolk Dance and Sea Pigeon. So they race to the top of the hill. Monk's Field takes a fractional lead from Paiute. Bird's Nest is very close, so is Connaught Ranger and Pollardstown. Then comes Sea Pigeon, behind Sea Pigeon, Royal Boxer, then Broadleys and finally Norfolk Dance. They're racing downhill now with three flights left to jump. And it's Monk's Field and Desi Hughes and Paiute and Martin Blackshaw from Bird's Nest. Connaught Ranger coming there. Pollardstown just in behind the leader. Sea Pigeon making good progress too as they come down to the third last. Monk's Field, Bird's Nest, Connaught Ranger, Paiute losing ground, Pollardstown coming there, Sea Pigeon only just in behind the leaders, and it's Monk's Field in the lead now from Pollardstown, Sea Pigeon just in behind them, Bird's Nest and Connaught Ranger very close, coming to the second last flight now in the champion hurdle, and it's Monk's Field in the lead from Bird's Nest, Pollardstown, Connaught Ranger, and just in behind them, Sea Pigeon over the second last, it was Monk's Field who led. Monk's Field in the lead from Pollardstown, Sea Pigeon coming there, then Bird's Nest, then comes Connaught Ranger and Royal Boxer, and rounding the home turn now in the champion hurdle, and it's Monk's Field in the lead from Bird's Nest and Sea Pigeon. Monk's Field, Sea Pigeon and Bird's Nest are the three principals as they come to the last. It's Monk's Field who's going to touch down just in the lead from Sea Pigeon. Monk's Field and Sea Pigeon, it's a repeat of last year. The same two fighting it out. Sea Pigeon coming there on the near side, and Sea Pigeon's going to avenge that defeat of last year. He's striding up to the line, the veteran 10-year-old. He's won it at last. Sea Pigeon wins the champion hurdle. Monk's Field is beaten for the first time in 3 years. Bird's Nest is third. Four is Royal Boxer. 5, 6 and 7 are Pollardstown, Connaught Ranger, Norfolk Dance.
So Sea Pigeon finally won the champion hurdle in 1980. Mick Easterby the trainer, Jonjo O'Neill on board. 13-2 the SP, 5 lengths back to Monk's Field, 6-5 favourite in second, with champion hurdle regular Bird's Nest in third at 11-1. So sweet revenge for Sea Pigeon, having been beaten into second place by Monk's Field the year before, drew clear on the run-in to win by a wide margin for a delighted Jonjo O'Neill. And Sea Pigeon was a short-priced 7-4 favourite on Heavy Going to follow up in 1981.
Stable companion Pollard starred together and Melodon jumps off. Melodon, fulfilling the role for which he was purchased, setting the pace as they come to the first of the eight flights and setting a good pace too. Melodon in the lead from Pollardstown and going straight. Those three set up a little gap there, and Ivan King has gone to the first. Ivan King, a faller at the first. The horse is up on his feet. His rider's yet to rise. They're racing towards the second flight now, and it's Melodon from Pollardstown, then going straight, and then Bird's Nest, followed by Mount Harvard and Daring Run. And then comes America's Marty's Anger. Just in behind them, Badsworth Boy and Slaney Idol and Sea Pigeon and Star Fen. Celtic Ride is the back marker at the moment, and Ivan King's jockey up on his feet all right, and Melodon in the lead from his stable companion Pollardstown, with going straight third and Bird's Nest four. Five is Mount Harvard and six Daring Run as they come to jump this flight. Melodon lands in the lead from Pollardstown, going straight. Then Bird's Nest and Mount Harvard and Daring Run. Then Badsworth Boy and Marty's Anger and Slaney Idol and Halen behind Halen and Sea Pigeon and then Celtic Ride. And now Starfin is the back marker as they race uphill with Melodon taking him along still from Pollardstown in second. Quite a gap then to going straight. A further long gap then to Bird's Nest. A gap, further gap now to Mount Harvard. They really getting strung out. Behind Mount Harvard is Daring Run, and then comes Marty's Anger and Sea Pigeon and Badsworth Boy and Halen and Starfin and Celtic Ride and Slaney Idol as they run downhill now. Melodon racing towards the third. The 1977 Daily Express Triumph hurdle winner in the lead from the 1979 winner Pollardstown. Then comes going straight in third place. A gap then of about 10 lengths to Bird's Nest, Mount Harvard and Daring Run, and then Badsworth Boy and Marty's Anger, and over that one still the same order. Among the first three, Melodon from Pollardstown, the blinkered Pollardstown. Then in third place, going straight. A long gap then to Mount Harvard and Daring Run and Bird's Nest and Marty's Anger and Badsworth Boy and Halen and Sea Pigeon and Slaney Idol and Starfin and Celtic Ride. As they come down towards the fourth flight, these two stable companions have set up a commanding advantage now. Melodon from Pollardstown, going straight, is in touch with them, but then there's a long gap to the fourth horse, which is Mount Harvard, then Daring Run close with him, then Bird's Nest on the inside, then Marty's Anger going well on the outer, then comes Halen. Behind Halen is Sea Pigeon making a bit of progress now, then comes Badsworth Boy on the inner, Slaley Idol, Celtic Ride, and finally Star Fen. As they race now uphill with four flights left to jump in the champion hurdle, and it's still Melodon from Pollardstown, a little between the two, a gap then to going straight in third. Then comes Daring Run four. Behind Daring Run is Mount Harvard, and then comes Marty's Anger, Sea Pigeon making a bit of ground. Behind them come Badsworth Boy and then Star Fen. Bird's Nest has dropped back to last. They're running downhill now. They've got three flights left to jump, and it's Pollardstown, the stable companion now of the longtime leader, Melodon, who's come to take a fractional advantage now. Then in third place is going straight. Then comes Daring Run. Sea Pigeon making significant progress towards the outside. Marty's Anger still very well in touch with them too. Coming down now to the third last flight with Pollardstown, the clear leader. Pollardstown jumps it in the lead from Badsworth Boy, who makes a mistake. Going straight on the inside, Marty's Anger still well in touch. Sea Pigeon coming there with his stable companion Star Fen. Coming down to the second last flight now, and it's Pollardstown from going straight and Daring Run. Then comes Badsworth Boy, Star Fen and Sea Pigeon at the second last. Pollardstown lands in the lead from Daring Run. Sea Pigeon still coming there strongly. Then Star Fen, they're racing round the home turn now, and it's Pollardstown being pressed by Daring Run and Sea Pigeon, and John Frankham coming there very strongly. Coming to the final flight, Pollardstown from Daring Run and Sea Pigeon. Sea Pigeon going very strongly with Star Fen on his outside over the last. Pollardstown and Daring Run, and it's Daring Run and Pollardstown being pressed now by Sea Pigeon. Daring Run in the lead from Sea Pigeon, coming to challenge on the near side. It's the old man Sea Pigeon coming to take it up, but he's going to win it as they come up towards the line. Sea Pigeon wins the champion hurdle. Sea Pigeon has just won it from Pollardstown and Daring Run. You've never heard just cheers from the crowd. Star Fen was four, then Slaney Island and Celtic Ride and Bird's Nest behind them going straight.
So with John Frankham aboard this time, Sea Pigeon followed up in 1981, the 7-4 favourite. Pollardstown at 9-1 in second, and Daring Run 15-2 in third, with Ted Walsh on board. Absolutely cantering, turning for home under John Frankham's Sea Pigeon, and he unleashed the 11-year-old after the last flight to score for his second champion hurdle win. However, he wasn't part of the lineup in 1982. Daring Run, third the previous year, was 9-4 favourite, ahead of Broadsword at 130, and Ekbalko, third favourite at 7-2.
It's the 14 runners being called in, and they're away. And coming to the first flight, Daring Rose is the first ashore. John Frankham on Daring Rose from Donegal, Prince and Migrator, with Holmeson just in behind them, and then Pollardstown. Daring Rose jumps out in the lead, but now a little between he and Donegal, Prince and Migrator between horses, and then Holmeson, and behind them come Another Story and Pollardstown, and then Gay Chance and For Auction and Holmore Star. Daring Run, one of the back markers at the moment, with Broadsword also. And it's Migrator now, Donegal, Prince, Daring Rose, and behind him Pollardstown and For Auction and Home Sun and Another Story and Holmore Star and Gay Chance and Potato Merchant and Ekbalko and Daring Run and Broadsword and Halen right over on the far side, and Donegal Prince lands over the second in the lead from very close with him, Migrator, then For Auction and Daring Rose, and nearest to us is Home Sun, and over on the far side Pollardstown with Gay Chance next, and then Holmore Star. And then Another Story and Halen and Potato Merchant and Broadsword and Daring Run and Ekbalko. Not going a great gallop at the moment in the champion hurdle, led by Donegal Prince, Migrator, Home Sun, Daring Rose, For Auction, Gay Chance, Pollardstown, Another Story, Holmore Star, then Ekbalko, Halen, Daring Run, Pollardstown, and the back marker Broadsword running downhill towards the next flight. Donegal Prince in the lead from Migrator in second. Daring Rose has lost his position and dropped right back to last now, and he's trying to pull up with John Frankham. John trying to keep him going, but he's pulled up. Daring Rose, the unpredictable, has pulled up and refused to jump that one. He's come to a full stop, and Donegal Prince is in the lead from Holmeson and Migrator and For Auction, and then Pollardstown. Then on the outside, Holmore Star. Just in behind them, Another Story and Gay Chance, and then Daring Run, Ekbalko towards the outside, Potato Merchant, and the back marker is Broadsword. As they jump the fourth, Donegal Prince landed in the lead from Migrator and Holmeson and For Auction and Pollardstown. Then Another Story and Gay Chance, Ekbalko on the outside. Just in behind them come Daring Run, Potato Merchant, and Halen now just been relegated to last place as they race towards the top of the hill and towards the fifth flight of the eight hurdles. And it's Donegal Prince in the lead from Migrator in second, then Holmeson third with Four Auction close. Behind him comes Pollardstown, then Ekbalko on the outside, and then Gay Chance, and then Another Story. Then Potato Merchant and Broadsword improving, and Daring Run has gone on the flat there. Daring Run has slipped up on the flat there and has unshipped Ted Walsh, who's just up on his feet, but the favourite is out of it. Halen is tailed off. The public have just been told over the public address. There's a howl of anguish from the Irish supporters of Daring Run as they run down now towards the third last in the champion hurdle. Donegal Prince is in the lead, being pressed by Migrator. Then over on the far side, coming there strongly, is Ekbalko. Broadsword is improving his place. Holmore Star's well there over the third last. Donegal Prince from Four Auction right in the battling line now. Then comes Gay Chance over on the far side. Then Ekbalko and Another Story. It's a very, very wide open race now as they come down towards the second last. Four Auction being pressed by Broadsword. And then Ekbalko over on the far side, and then Gay Chance. But it's Four Auction with the advantage from Broadsword, going very strongly just in behind the leaders. Ekbalko right there with them, and then Holmore Star. They're coming down towards the final flight now, and it's Four Auction being pressed by Ekbalko and Broadsword. Broadsword between horses. Four Auction over on the far side. Four Auction lands in the lead from Ekbalko and Broadsword. They're racing into the closing stages, and it's Four Auction being pressed by Ekbalko and Broadsword. Four Auction for Ireland from Ekbalko and Broadsword as they race up towards the line. It's going to be another Irish triumph and a shock victory too. For Auction wins the champion hurdle. Second is Broadsword, third Ekbalko, four Pollardstown, five Gay Chance, and then came Holmore Star, and behind him Donegal Prince and Another Story.
Trainer Michael Cunningham and amateur Colin Magnier team up with For Auction to win at 40-1 by a wide margin, seven lengths back to Broadsword, 100-30. In second with Ekbalko, third at 7-2. Daring Run was the favourite but slipped up. And with Daring Run out of the race, it was set up